Hi everybody, this is Laura again. Today it is February 15th and I just did a review about a Harriet Tubman movie that I absolutely recommend you see. And continuing with Black History Month, I am reviewing a movie I absolutely love. This is my second favorite, maybe even my first favorite of Spike Lee. This is the first Amazon motion picture either ever made at all, or at least the first Amazon motion picture for Spike Lee. It's about Chi-Town, which is Chicago, the Windy City, and it's based on an old Greek play called Lysistrata. From what Chirac is trying to convey, Lysistrata is a play about women trying to stop men from warfare. Endless warfare, like Alexander the Great, you know. Maybe it was written in that era. I didn't bother to research, really. But Chirac is really a great movie. I really love it. Nick Cannon is in it. Wesley Snipes, Samuel L. Jackson, John Cusack, Angela Bassett. And then who is this lady? Tiana Paris. There's a whole bunch of people in this playing various roles. And I just think it's a really excellent film. It's about two gangs. It's like two fictitious gangs in Chicago. The Spartans and the Trojans. And the Spartans, I believe, wear orange, and the Trojans wear purple. I may be completely mistaken. I'll figure it out. I saw it about two nights ago, and I just thought, wow, this is a really cool movie. It's just so unique. It defies genre. There's comedy in it, there's drama in it, there's spirituality in it, it's like it rhymes, most of the dialogue rhymes, so you almost feel like you're in a Dr. Seuss morality play, but at the same time it's totally serious about its message. This main character, Chirac, is played by Nick Cannon. And he has a girlfriend, played by Tiana Paris. Oh yeah, Jennifer Hudson and David Patrick Kelly. I think I heard a little Phoebe Sweeney, Dave Chappelle. I knew I recognized him. I heard a little, kind of, it almost sounded like a tribute to David Patrick Kelly, because he was the one in that movie The Warriors, which was also about gangs. He was the one that said, "Warriors, come out to play!" I think I heard a little tribute to him. He played the most hilarious character in this. It was just, I just thought I was going to die laughing. So, anyway, it's Chirac. He is just, there's a shooting in the beginning of the movie, and it's Angela Bassett's daughter, Patty, I believe it is. The little girl's name is Patty, and she's shot dead. by Stray Bullet. That was she, and the stray bullet hit her and killed her during gunfire, and it seems like these gangs don't care who gets in their path, you know. And that's when the women in this neighborhood all band together, even the, you know, they're even on opposite sides with their gang, you know, the orange gang and the purple gang, and they decide that they aren't gonna stand it for it anymore. And so if the men don't stop fighting and killing and, you know, causing little kids to drop dead in the streets, they're not gonna get any more booty. So I really liked it. It was just great. I love the Tiana Paris. I love the performance she does, and all the other girl gangsters that, you know, decide to, like, you know, bury the hatchet and join her in her quest. And then all over the world, you see in Japan, in Russia, in all over the planet, you know, people revolting, females revolting, and saying, if the violence doesn't stop, we're gonna... And it is, you know, in that way, unfortunately, it is sort of a fantasy. But it's very touching. It's very touching to see the community just withholding something these men want from their women because they care so much about innocent children and innocent people. And the men even get really aggressive, and one of the men gets a bitch slap for his trouble. I love that part too. And John Cusack, boy, his voice sounds really hoarse. Poor guy. Maybe he yelled a lot during rehearsal and he got a hoarse voice, but he was really good in this movie. But his voice was so hoarse and ragged. I just don't know. He did a great job, though. The climax of the movie kind of comes, and I don't want to spoil it. It comes when our main character finally has to drop to his knees and beg somebody for forgiveness. And that was touching as well. I cried, I laughed. It was just one of the most excellent, excellent movies I had seen. So unique, so in defiance of any genre, really. It was just so full of genre. So full of mixed genre, I should say. And I think Samuel L. Jackson was hilarious. He just, as the narrator, I don't remember the Greek name they gave him, but something like Dulcimedes or something like that. I'll get it right, don't worry. But he really kind of tied it together. So yeah, I would give this 10 out of 10. It's really great. I'm proud of Spike Lee because he's done so many excellent movies that if you don't have Amazon Prime or Amazon Video, you should get it just for this movie. Anyway, that'll be it for now. Happy Black History Month.